hear a piece of brass tonight, a couple of pieces, just breaks up the song. I used to have a bandmaster Ivan Walls, Barbara's late husband, and whenever we did a band program, he would get me to sing a solo. But he used to say, when introducing me, "I've got Malcolm on the program to break it up." We're going to sing two songs now, both sort of a bit tongue-in-cheek, I guess. They've got a serious message. First one is "Don't let the devil turn you around." That's a good message. But it's presented in quite a swinging fashion. And the second one is a song that's written really in a barbershop style. And that's called "That's the Difference Jesus Can Make." Now, if the songs can start doing some actions, which they will, and you want to join in with those actions, that's okay. If you want to join in the singing, don't do that. If you know the words, you can sing by all means. So that's the difference, and don't let the devil. Thank you.
two, you were sort of getting the victory and sort of. So I think what we should do, Mark, if that's okay, if we do the last way you change key, and if you'd like to, if you feel comfortable, and if you don't feel comfortable, then you will never get spoken to again. All right. It's just a little gentle movement. Just gentle. We don't need to go bump into the person. Just a little left and a right. Okay? So you've got to go that way. Okay? If you want to. If you don't want to, be miserable. We don't care. Okay? Here we go. Oakengates before, it was a long time ago, when I lived in Hednesford and I was thinking about becoming a Salvation Army officer, the corps officer at the time said, I'll tell you what, why don't you go to Oakengates and do an over 60 club meeting? I said, when is it? They said, on a Monday. And it was back in the old hall, round the corner. And so I thought, I'll catch the train from Wolverhampton. So I caught the train from Wolverhampton, I got my ticket, got on the train, and I was on the way to Shrewsbury, stopping off at Oakengates, and the ticket inspector came round, and he said, tickets please. I gave him my ticket, he said, oh, I'm so sorry. I said, what? He said, we don't stop at Oakengates on a Monday. I said, I was in Salvation Army uniform, you know, trying to impress as a possible officer. I said, well, I've got to the Salvation Army because I'm doing their over 60s meeting. Well, I'm so sorry. We don't stop at Oakengates on a Monday. I said, well, I've promised I'm going to become a Salvation Army officer one day. He said, I'm ever so sorry. But this train doesn't stop at Oakengates on a Monday. He said, I'll tell you what I can do, and this is the best thing I can do. He said, come and see me at the front of the train just before we get into Oakengate station. I'll pull down the window of the train. I'll hold you by your collar. I'll lift you out of the window. You start your legs running. And then when we get to the platform, have you heard this before? I'll let go of you and you can, you know, eventually get to Oakengates because this train doesn't stop at Oakengates on a Monday. I thought, well, I'll have to do it. So I knew that we'd just gone through Wolverhampton, we were on our way to Shrewsbury, and so I went up to the ticket collector and said, are we nearly there? He looked out and he said, yes, yeah, we're almost here. He said, are you ready? And I said, well, I'll be ready as ever I can be. So I get to the front of the train. He pulls the window of the train, shows how old it was, the train. Remember those windows we used to have, you know, the carriages? He said, are you ready? I said, yes. So he got hold of my collar. I get out of the train, my little legs start pumping. He said, are you ready to let go, for me to let go? I said, well, okay, I will do. So we were coming into Oakengate station. He let me down. My little legs were pumping, and got onto the station. The train went back. I started slowing down. The next thing I knew, somebody pulled my collar and pulled me in at the back of the train. And the bloke at the back of the train said, Salvation Army, I bet it's important. I saw you running to catch the train. And I thought, he's going to miss it. He's going to miss it. So I pulled you in. Of course, this train doesn't stop. Normally I get applause when I finish that. She would have been here, but she's working at this weekend. Yeoma and I have been happily married now for 32 years. We've actually been married for 35, but only 32 have been married. And we were on a holiday in St. Ives earlier on, and she said, earlier on in August, she said, "Do you know, it's 35 years since we've been married this year," she said, "and I'm wearing something that fitted me when we got married." I said to her, "It's a scarf." Yeah, I remember meeting Yoma, we met at the training college, her hair blowing in the wind, and she too proud to run after it. Yeah. Those are my corny jokes about Yoma. By the way, the word Yoma is a name of a volcano range in Burma. I just thought I'd mention that. But isn't it interesting? We got married New Year's Eve 1988, which was a Saturday. And I chose that day, New Year's Eve, A, because it was a Saturday and everybody could get there. Secondly, because I wouldn't forget when I was getting married New Year's Eve. And thirdly, most important, was that because it was New Year's Eve, as an officer, I'd be at the watch light service, so I couldn't afford to take her out because I'd be at the army. But interestingly enough, on my right here is Major Ruth. Now, Major Ruth, when we got married, you reminded me, Major Ruth, of the fact that the day after we got married, you were on divisional headquarters in the East Midlands Division, and you led the meeting the day after Yoma and I got married. So it's taken me 35 years to say thank you ever so much for leading our worship when we were on honeymoon. We had a lovely honeymoon. I was in Conductor and Yoma went to York. There we go. Okay. Now, I sort of write music at different times of the year for different reasons. And sometimes people send me music or send me words and I write a particular melody to it. Such is the case of this one. This is the second public performance of a little chorus that I wrote with a guy called Rob Little. Rob is a Salvationist at Warrington, up there near Manchester. Oh, it's Cheshire, isn't it? Oh, better not say Cheshire. Sorry, Warrington in Cheshire. And so he's provided the words, just a couple of verses. It's like a prayer chorus, really. But after we've sung this, we're going to have an interval. And the interval is to allow you a comfort break. Is there anything else?
There will be a cold drink.
There'll be cold drink at £5, so...
Well, actually, quite seriously, you didn't pay anything to come in.
No.
We're worth a lot of money, but we are really charged.
Yeah.
80 quid a ticket, I reckon. But what we would like you to do, and I think the Treasurer might be able to help us with a box or something, there are expenses involved in a weekend like this, so we've not had a charge to come in, but... We're going to charge you to go out, no, we're not really. We would like you to make a free will offering just to offset some of our expenses. Are you happy about that?
Yeah.
Well, too bad if you're not.
Thank you.
just a 5 to 10 minutes, no longer.
Okay then, to God be the glory. Do you understand?
Yes.
Let your love work its way.
83 Sarahs. CD will be coming out soon. Oh, lovely song. Isn't it lovely? Yeah. Music has that great ability, doesn't it, to speak to us, you know, and to challenge us. And when we hear words like that, then we've got to do something about that, I think. Unless we're really stubborn and you know, we ignore what that, those words are saying. And that song, I think, is for somebody here this evening. It's probably more than one person. Something touched my heart and made me feel grateful for the music, Christian music certainly, with lyrics that speak to us like that. So thank you very much indeed for three stories. Now, what we have the ability to do within the Salvation Army is to change tack, change sounds, change experiences. And so the next song we're going to sing is completely different to the one that we've just heard. But hopefully it will be okay as well. I've had a good friend, or we have a good friend within the Salvation Army, Stephen Poxon, who with his wife Major Heather Poxon, belong to the Corps at St Albans. And Stephen and I have collaborated over many years. And this was a song that we collaborated with, and I think I've actually said when it is. This was in Ealing on June the 7th, 2011, I wrote this song. Okay? So what's that? That's 11, almost 13 years ago. No, over 13 years. Okay? So I hope it doesn't sound like a 13-year-old song. All right? Anybody here got a 13-year-old car? I've got a 22-year-old car that made it from Woking last night, so I'm doing pretty well. But it is a Golf, a VW Golf, which sort of lasts forever, which is a good thing. So here's the bright and breezy number called Hymn of Praise. It's the sort of song that when you get to the end, you'll instinctively, without knowing, put your hands together to applaud. It will be absolutely fantastic. That's what you'll do, because you've been so impressed by the singing. You try it. I can promise you that when we get to the end and we say the word you, okay, you see what happens to your hands. You mark my words. So here we go. This is Hymn of Praise with a bit of brass as well. Or as you say in Oakengates, a bit of brass. Brass, yeah. Coming from Hednesford, you can do brass. Oh, we've only got two. Oh, come on, Peter. Where have you got two now? Is he gone? What's he doing? Is he warming up or what? Come on. We've got time. It's 8:10 already. Big round of applause to Peter. On your own time. you so much for your spontaneous and rapturous applause. I told you it would happen. Yeah, I know you were trying not to, but instinctively, you were there, weren't you? Thank you very much to the brass players, both of them. All three. Now, when you get to my age, which is 70, you forget things. Have you noticed that? Even if you knock 70, you forget things. And do you know what I forgot? I forgot my message for this evening. I forgot what I was going to say to you. I left a piece of paper at home on the computer. Okay? So what you do when you're an officer and you've forgotten you improvise under the Holy Spirit's guidance. Okay? So this is what I was going to say, but I hope that you'll gain something from what I will say. Paul wrote to the Roman church, and he wrote this. He said, "Love must be sincere, hate what is evil, cling to what is good, bless those who persecute, bless those and do not curse, rejoice with those who rejoice, mourn with those who mourn, live in harmony with one another." And when I looked at the programme this evening, I thought there is one thing that's missing from the programme. And it's what every Saturday night Salvation Army programme should have. And that is a piano duet. Don't you agree? Yeah. Who said no? every Salvation Army evening programme should have a piano duet with two of the finest pianists that you can find in Oakengates on a Saturday night. And so, at no expense, with a little bit of rehearsal, not a lot. You used to say that, Phil Daniels, wasn't it? No, Paul Daniels. Phil Daniels is the actor, but never mind. No relation. So, at great expense, with Kathy and I are going to play a beautiful duet, and it's entitled Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Okay, so be blessed as we pray. You like this one, Mark? Yeah. You'll be amazed at how good this is after just 30 seconds of rehearsal.
This is without music as well.
Tomorrow morning, fortunately, I have got my meeting plan, and I have got this. I'd be lovely to see you if you can come at 10 o'clock. If you're not here, then go somewhere else, if you can, on Sunday. So the meeting plan for tomorrow, the theme of tomorrow is, we can't all sing, but we all have a voice. We can't all sing, but we all have a voice. Now some of you can sing, I know that. So living in harmony is part of that voice that God gives to us. That wonderful grace that he gives to us, that is in the person of our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. It's a wonderful thing to know Jesus. It's a wonderful thing to know Jesus. Thank you. It's a wonderful thing to know Jesus. And part of that expression of love is that we surrender ourselves to God. He wants all there is of us. And that's the tension sometimes that we have. I don't need to have that bit of my life. I'm okay as I am. But I surrender all. And when we do that to God, he will use us through his Holy Spirit to let other people know that we can actually live in harmony one with another. So here's the old gospel song written by a lady in America in 1860 that sort of went around in my mind, and I think I wrote this in 2012, actually, in Ealing. Ealing must have been a good year for us, I'm not too sure why. So here's I Surrender All.
Thank you.
Now, when I was at Hednesford, I was grateful. We were grateful to have a pianist. And really, this man inspired me to learn to play the piano. I hope I don't get too upset, because back in the day, as a seven-year-old, I used to stand behind the pianist at Hednesford, and I used to marvel at how he played the piano. So this lady here, which is my Auntie Marion, her husband David, who's sadly gone to glory a number of years ago, was the core pianist. And I used to stand over, I was in the white band, so I knew what notes were, but I didn't quite know how he managed to play the way he played. He had such a lovely sort of style, just lovely. And I used to stand over him and used to watch him play in the Sunday evening. And what I did when I get home, when I got home, was I knew that when he played that key on the piano, that was a C. And I knew when he pressed that note on the piano, it was a D. And I knew that when he pressed that note on the piano, it was an A, because I knew what the stage were. And so when he used to go home, whenever I saw a C on a piece of music, I played that note. Are you with me? Whenever I saw a piece of music with a D, I played that note. And whenever I saw any other note, I pressed that note. Because looking at David, I sort of remembered how he played, I remembered what he played. And that's how I learned to play the piano, by remembering how David played. It's quite interesting. I didn't have lessons, I just sort of watched him and then went back and learned. So in a sense, Uncle David, David, my Auntie Marion's husband, was such an inspiration with others at Hensfield. As a musician, and certainly writing music. Now, so David was a pianist and a lovely member of the corps, and some of you here have been singing for a long, long time. Now, there's somebody here who's been singing for 60 years, and her name is Jean. Is Jean somewhere? Jean Dudley. Is that you? Is that, are you Jean? You look like a Jean. Somehow. So, you've been singing a lot at home. You've been playing an instrument as well? 60. Is it 60 years? Well, we've got something here for you, Jean. It's just a piece of paper, there's nothing on it. It's a letter, that's you, Oldbury Corps. And you've also got a certificate of appreciation. I'll read it to you, just in case your eyes start filling them. This is an appreciation of faithful service. And even though you haven't sung the right parts, all this time. This is a certificate of appreciation of faithful service, and it is awarded to Jean Dudley for 60 years loyal service as a songster at Oldbury Corps and Willenhall and Hednesford, and it's signed by the Division Commander, October 2023. And it says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not unto his own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. So in a minute, these good people here are going to stand and they're going to clap. Okay, as I present you this certificate. Is there going to be a photo? Is there going to be a photograph opportunity for somebody to take a photo? It should be. Should be. Yeah. Here we go. So. All right. So let's stand and give Jimmy a round of applause.
of dropping this next song, because we thought, well, maybe we don't want to keep it here till goodness knows where, but the time isn't too bad. But when I suggested that we didn't sing this, well, my goodness, it was uproar. Wasn't there? They nearly lynched me. So I said it was John's idea. But I can understand why they want to sing this song. It's really, really beautiful. And the words are very, very challenging. And they're going to come up on the screen, I think, when we sing the words, "When God Comes Near." As Major John has already said, if you come tonight and there's a burden on your heart, you don't know what it is, but there's something missing in your life, well, let God come near and He'll bless you as we sing. We're going to sing this song, and then Andrew's going to bring us the last of his solos before we have a finale, really, a great song to finish.
Songster reservists, I've been asked to give the thanks this evening. So I do really want to say thank you for this evening, for the inspiration that you have actually brought to this place, this day. So thank you very much indeed for that. I often think of Oakengates Songsters as being a gem, that's a hidden gem in Oakengates, but in Telford, in fact, the wider town. And I'm always thrilled and blessed by the events when we see them in their full glory. This evening, the collaboration with Oldbury, Willenhall and Hednesford Songsters, we have received a musical treat. If you agree with that, then I would ask you to give a round of applause. I do, of course, give thanks to God for the way He comes into our lives and the way He transforms our lives, and for the way in which He uses our abilities. And I wanted to say this evening that I'd like to give a special word of thanks to the pianist who often is in the got her on her feet and to the side of the piano so you can actually see. I wanted to give a thanks to the drummer. Yeah. You may not have seen him in the congregation because I couldn't see him when I was down there. And for the bass guitarist, soloists, thank you very much, the three Sarahs. You know, I love to hear you singing, and I love to hear you singing together even more. For the band accompaniment, or the musical accompaniment there, just superb as it always is. I'm not sure how to describe the duet on the piano, but I'll just leave that for you to ponder. We are so grateful, aren't we, that we've been able to spend this time here this evening. And I hope that as you leave tonight, that there will be a spring in your step as you depart. Lastly, I'd like to thank Malcolm Hampton, the Songster leader for Oakengates, for putting the programme together. And of course to Major Martin, for coming and joining us this weekend. We enjoyed you this afternoon, and we're looking forward very much to 10 o'clock tomorrow morning when we know we'll see more of you and your personality. So thank you, one and all. Thank you.
And there was, of course, a group of people that kept us going all day by giving us a tea and food, and generally making us look very, very welcome. Pam was the head of the thank you. All those who contributed, we do thank you very much. Well, this is our finale, our last piece. It's a fabulous piece of music. If you don't get stirred in your heart by this, then there's something wrong. And if you think, you want to speak to somebody and say, God has spoken to me and I need to do something about it, then please do so. It's an old song, it's Charles Wesley, and Can It Be? And but this is an outstanding arrangement of this beautiful song. you conclude with a prayer. Father God, we ask your blessing on all that's taken place tonight. We've enjoyed being with each other. We've enjoyed that fellowship. We've enjoyed making music. But we want, at the close of this day, to give the glory all to you. Thank you, Jesus. We look forward to a good day tomorrow.